Hello everyone, I'm Gaurav from Logitudes and welcome back to our PHP web development tutorial series. Okay, and so we are going to start with our programming right now. And before programming in PHP, we need some resources over here. Okay, and the first thing we need is our XAMPP server. So we have installed our XAMPP server right now. Okay, in my computers here, in C drive here and XAMPP. Okay, so these are the files in XAMPP server. First of all, to start with our XAMPP server, I'm going and starting this XAMPP control.exe. Here opens my window for the XAMPP, and you can see my Apache and MySQL is running, already running. So what this Apache is? This Apache is basically the server. Apache provides as a server to makes our system as a server and provides us capabilities to do server-side programming languages. And this MySQL enables us to interact with the MySQL database or PHP MyAdmin database. Okay, so this is how we start with our server. You can just stop and start it from here and do. And the next thing, next important thing in PHP is whatever site we wanted to develop, we just host it in this htdocs. Okay, so let's go and make a new folder here, right here, and let's name it as Logic PHP. Okay, so whatever we are going to develop in PHP, we are going to use this Logic PHP folder as a main website. Okay, now as our server is running and we have mint our first file for PHP, let's go and access this file and see what happens. Okay, so now let me go into the close all other tabs. Fine, close tabs. Now to access this website, we have to go and write like localhost slash and then my website name. This particular localhost directs the root here, okay, in the XAMPP htdocs. So we are going to write localhost and then logic php. Okay, so we have our directory right here, and it says in index of logic php, whatever directories are here, we are going to include it here. Okay, so let's first see what is there if we just go and build a simple PHP code. Okay, like this only. I'll explain you right now what was that. Okay, and then we are going to save it in our folder right here as say PHP template. And the extension that we use for the PHP, particular PHP language to tell the server that the file is the PHP type of file, we use simply PHP. Okay, so right here we built the first file in PHP, and now let me refresh this page and see what happens. Okay, so we have a file here like PHP dot PHP template dot PHP, and we can click and go to the file there. But what happens when we load our website? It don't look like this. Okay, and there must be some page that will be the initial page, or you must say that whenever a website loads, the first page to load is already given there. Okay, so that is the index page actually. So if you don't want your website look like this or your project look like this, okay, we wanted to go and include one more file here and name it as index.php. Now right after that, if you save this file and now we are going to refresh it, then the all the matter is gone, because the index is now loading, all automatically loading this particular index.php, but not loading the directory of that file, because that server knows that inside the, if there is a file that named as index.php, that must be the first file to load and show to the user. So this is the file that we installed, we created first in the PHP language. So close this one right now, and now come to here. We are discussing here. Okay, so in this PHP script, first we are going to learn some basics. And what is this? Okay, so particularly we know, like every markup language or any programming language, we used to program between tags. Okay, so these are the, this is the opening tag of a PHP. Whenever we wanted to include a PHP inside a HTML or wherever, we need an opening and a closing tag. So this is a opening tag for the PHP, and this is the closing tag for PHP. Okay, and another thing is my is comment. So to comment, to use the comment, we use this particular tag. Okay, or not this and this one. Okay, so this is the opening comment tag and this is the closing comment tag. For multi-line, we use this. Like if you write we are learning PHP here, okay, and you wanted this comment to be a multi-line comment, then you can use these tags under which you can define the multi-line comment. But there's another way to comment in the PHP, and that is the double forward slash, and you can write we are learning PHP. Okay, by this you can give PHP a command that this is a single line command, single line comment. But if you divide the line here, the comment is no more valid. Okay, and if you go and save this project right now, save this file and go refresh this page, then you can see okay, there's a line 12 error here. Okay, fine, that must be some error I don't sipped about. Okay, but because this is not under any function right now, there's an error. But what are the comments? These are the other things that PHP don't show. Okay, because it knows that there are something inside these opening and closing comment tags, and those must not be included into our programming. So this is how we use to comment and start our PHP. Okay, so in our first program, in our PHP, we are going to display something, okay, and like we are going to display a hello world program as any other programming language we do. So for displaying, for giving user an output, okay, there is a token named as echo. Okay, so here's we use echo to display the output of anything, okay, whether it is a text or image or whatever, okay, but not in an array. In that case we will discuss about later. So for echo, if you are giving a string as an output, then you have to use this inverted these commas, inverted commas, or this colons. Okay, so we are using this type of structure in PHP to give any type of string output. So this is how we wanted to write hello world to logic cues. Okay, so this is how we give a string as an output to the user. Now go and refresh the page and you can see hello world to the logic cues. Okay, the one other thing that we include in our PHP is PHP is a hypertext preprocessor. That means it can be embedded with the hypertext language. Okay, and the hypertext markup language is obviously HTML. So we can also use tags like h1 and closing tag for h1 here to display our text right there. So this is how we embed a PHP inside a hypertext markup language. So you can just go and write into a single line. Okay, and we're going to end it up right there. And yes, we are done. And now go and refresh the page and you can see the text got the properties of the markup h1. Okay, so this is how we embed the PHP language, PHP programming, PHP script inside a markup language. So these are the very important things that how to initiate and how to embed the PHP into the other markup languages. Okay, so that's all for this particular tutorial. In next tutorial we are going to get into some really cool and interesting stuff about PHP. So thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, share or comment if any doubt, and do subscribe our channel to keep watching our videos. Thank you.